Valens Research, Uniform Financial Analytics.
For those of you who don't know EW Scripps owns, their biggest business is they own broadcast TV stations. So your local NBC or Fox or CBS or ABC affiliate, they own and operate that business. And they're the ones who basically, when you tune in, they're the ones who run it, right? They, along with competitors like SPGI, right, which is Sinclair and others, are big players in the space. What immediately jumps out to us when we look at this on a uniform accounting basis is a couple things. The first thing that's really telling is look at how as-reported metrics understate this company's profitability. It's no wonder that people have been talking about how this is a declining, dying business for years, because of the fact that they look at as-reported metrics, and as-reported metrics have never broken 5% really since all the way back in 2012. And even before then, it wasn't 2005. In reality, over the last 5+ years, this company has been way more profitable than as-reported metrics reflect, and that people who misunderstand the business think that it is. But there's a flip side here, right? On an as-reported basis, you say, oh, no wonder it's trading at a 10 times PE, because it's a low return and declining business. Here's the thing. It's not trading at a 10 times multiple though. It's trading at a 22 times multiple. It's trading at market average valuations, which is important because unless you think that this business really won't fade at all, I mean, and the point is it's not dying, but it is a melting ice cube, certainly. Unless you think that melting ice cube is going to stop melting, it's trading at market average valuations doesn't really make any sense. The market expectations for kind of continued asset growth on an organic basis with returns to be this high, all of a sudden you go, hold on, this isn't a low return business that's generating a low PE, right? This is a business that has been good, but certainly still has macro headwinds pushing it down and potentially disrupting its subscribers and its revenue. And yet it's trading at a 22 times multiple. The market is basically saying this company is going to stay here forever. So the thing that's an issue is when this company was trading at a 10 times multiple, which what you think it is on an as reported basis, if you think it can survive longer than people are expecting, right, then all of a sudden it looks cheap, right? It's at worst fairly valued and could be undervalued. When you look at a business that is stable, but is a melting ice cube, right, it is losing subscribers every single year, and you say it's also trading at a 22 times multiple, that's market average multiples, all of a sudden at best, it's fairly valued. But if returns decline or if growth slows down, it's an overvalued name. It's not a name that you would want to be spending any time on. You are having a totally different conversation looking at the right data, right? You've got an expensive company, not a cheap company. You've got a melting ice cube business that's been good, but couldn't possibly stay good versus already a weak business. Totally different discussion.
Valens Research, the world's leading source for uniform financial analytics.